Gas chromatography is a type of chromatography technique mainly used for separation of a compound that is naturally volatile or it is easily converted to a volatile derivative. This GC useful in separation of a number of small organic and inorganic compounds based on type of stationary phase and mobile phase. We are categorizing the gas chromatography techniques into two types. If the stationary phase is solid, mobile phase is gas. We are calling it as gas solid chromatography. The principle involved is adsorption. The stationary phase is liquid, the mobile phase is gas. We are calling it as gas liquid chromatography. That is nothing but GLC. In most cases, we are calling it the normal gas chromatography. The principle is partition. So what is meant by partition means distribution of a sample or a compound in between two immiscible liquids is called as partition. So when we are injecting sample into a stationary phase, so along with the mobile phase, the compound is traveling through the stationary phase. Depending upon the affinity between the stationary phase and analyte, they are separated with different affinities. The affinity between stationary phase and the analyte is more, they are travels very slowly. So which is having more affinity, they will be travels very fast along with the carrier gas. So the which one is eluted first, that will be shows the first peak in the chromatogram of the gas chromatography. The second, the here, the first, the red colored samples are separated. So we are getting red, a peak of the red color sample. After that, blue color. Then after some time, we are getting the blue color peak. And at the last, the yellow color compounds are eluted from the column of stationary phase. So in this way, the compounds are separated based on their affinity and their distribution with the distribution of the compound with the stationary phase and mobile phase. So the criteria of a compound to be analyzed by GC. So what is the criteria for a compound to analyze by using a GC? So compulsory, the compound should be volatile in nature. It is easily converted to volatile derivative upon giving the little amount of temperature. So now we are giving the temperature or heating, thermal energy. That time only the state of matter should be converted from the liquid state to gas state. But there is no change in the chemical composition. So that's why compulsory, whatever the compounds we are analyzing, that should be thermostable. These are the two criteria, volatile in nature and thermostable. The instrumentation of gas chromatography. So as the mobile phase is carrier gas, compulsory we have to use a cylinder which will be store the carrier gas with high pressure. So the first is the carrier gas. Now the carrier gas is flowing through some pressure with a constant flow. To read the flow of the carrier gas, we are using flow regulators. So the carrier gas is traveling. To the flow of carrier gas, we are injecting a sample. The sample is also converted into gaseous form. Now the carrier gas and the sample, we are injected through the injector, they are passing towards the chromatographic column. So where the separation will be occurred after the eluted compounds entered into the detector. The detector will give the electrical signal, then it will be going to the recorder where the data processing or integration will be happen. So these are the different parts of the instrumentation. Carrier gas, flow regulators, injector, chromatographic column, and detector, and recorder are readout devices. These are the main parts of the instruments. The first part is carrier gas. So this is a block diagram or schematic representation of a gas chromatography. And here we are having one column oven also. The column oven we have to use to maintain a temperature to provide the temperature for a compound to maintain in the gaseous state. So these are the different parts, and this is the schematic representation of a gas chromatography. So first the carrier gas. The common carrier gases include helium, hydrogen, nitrogen and argon. The most commonly used carrier gases are helium, hydrogen and nitrogen. Among these three, we are using helium and nitrogen. These are the most commonly used. We are four are there. Among that four, we are using helium and nitrogen because of less expensive. And choice of the carrier gas and what are the advantages and disadvantages of the carrier gases. So what is the ideal characteristic of a carrier gas? So we are using the carrier gas, it will be carries the our analyte towards the column for separation. Yes? So that's why the ideal characteristic of a carrier gas is chemically inert, and the carrier gas should have high purity and suitable to type of detector. So we are using a certain carrier gases for a certain detector. In the GC we have different type of detectors are there. So we are using certain type of carrier gases for certain type of detectors only. So the first carrier gas is hydrogen. So it is used with the thermal conductivity detector. It is very suitable for the detector is thermal conductivity detector. This is also one type of universal detector. In general, we have two types of universal detectors. The detector is refractive index detector and thermal conductivity detector. So when we are using thermal conductivity detector in the GC, that time we are using the carrier gases are hydrogen and sometimes we are using helium also. So the thermal conductivity detector used with the carrier gases like hydrogen and helium. The hydrogen advantages are it is very cheap, low density, and it gives the most time efficient separation. And the disadvantages is it reacts with the unsaturated compounds and it is inflammable. So it is react with the unsaturated compounds like that time it is a reductive gas. That's why we are calling it as it is a reductive gas. It can have an explosive mixture with air. So that's why it is called like inflammable. And some industries, some countries have regulated against the use of hydrogen because of these disadvantages. Next, helium, it is very inert. It will not react with any analyte. It gives very efficient separation, non-flammable. So compared to the hydrogen, the helium is the very good one. Chemically inert, it won't react with any analyte or anything with the column or carrier gas. And it gives a efficient separation and no flammable, but hydrogen is having the some flammable in nature. But it is having some expensive compared to the hydrogen. A non-replenishable resource this is. Next, nitrogen, it is very cheap and it is also inert. It cannot react with any analyte and no flammable. But the efficiency is very narrow range. So that's why it is having some disadvantage. So these are the different type of carrier gases we are using. So the ideal characteristics are chemically inert, high purity, and easily available, suitable to type of detector. These are the carrier gases. Next is flow regulators. So when the carrier gas is stored in the cylinder with high pressure, they are traveling with some flow. So to regulate or to maintain the constant flow of any carrier gas, we are using flow regulators. So So to regulate the pressure and control the gas flow through the separation column. So these are the flow. In general, we are using two types of flow regulators in the gas chromatography or GC. So first one is rotameter. Second one is the soap bubble meter. So from gas cylinder, the gas is flowing in this direction from the bottom of the rotameter. So in this rotameter, it is made up of a glass tube. And it is having a one spring. Above the spring, one float in a form of round spherical shaped float will be there. In general, this float will be made up of some aluminium or silica. So it is having glass tube and spring and float. And the glass tube having some pre-calibrated measurements. So these are the measurements. So when the gas will be flowing, depending upon the pressure and flow of the carrier gas, that time the carrier gas will be give some force to the spring, that time the float will be moving towards the upward direction. So the moving towards the upward direction, and it will be going to a certain distance at upward direction, that measures the flow of the carrier gas with the pressure. And the soap bubble meter, in this soap bubble meter, it is having a one rubber bulb. In this rubber bulb, soap solution is stored. Above the rubber bulb, it is connected with a glass tube. This glass tube having a calibrated tube, nothing but it is having some measurements. And it is, this total entire setup is connected to the gas flow. So when the gas is flowing towards in this direction, when the gas is entered into the soap bubble meter, when we press this rubber bulb, the soap solution will be moving upward to this gas flow. The solution is converted to the soap bubble, and the soap bubble is moving towards the upward direction, and it will be going to a certain distance. So the length of distance represents the pressure or flow of the our carrier gas. So here we are discussing this one. There are two types: rotameter, soap bubble meter. Rotameter consists of a tapered tube, typically made up of a glass with a float held on a spring. The level of float is determined by the flow rate of the carrier gas. Soap bubble meter, it consists of a glass tube with the inlet for the carrier gas. A rubber bulb is used to store the soap solution. When bulb is gently pressed, a drop of solution is converted to a bubble by the pressure of the carrier gas and travels in the upward direction. The distance traveled upward is a measures the flow rate of the carrier gas. So these are the different type of flow regulators in the GC.